has been really hard after the pandemic started to open such a communication channel that will allow for people to see you for who you are, to make them trust you, to make them believe you. So that when there is an issue, which inevitably happens, it's part of the job, basically, to manage a team, that there will be an issue that will hit somebody from your team quite powerfully. And how would you help them? How would you support them in that moment without being close to them? As a leader, to be able to trust that this relationship, even if it's online, works in that regard, in that context as well, then you need to build a very strong communication, very open communication with them. Make myself, you could say, vulnerable. Vulnerable is a very broad term in that case, but what does it mean for me is that I open myself. I share about my life. I share about myself. I am empathic. I ask questions, which people, I try to put myself in their position, and then I ask them how they feel, what they do, how was it today, ask them about their family. You know, I make a step towards my own vulnerability to open myself so that I could show that they could do the same if they want to. Of course, it's not necessary, but if they want to. And so far, it has almost always worked, because in that way, people see me for who I am. There is always a meeting where the full team can contribute, where the full team can stick together, because there needs to be a team feeling. We are a family. I see the quality assurance to a big extent being a family, and then because everybody works in their own regarding agile teams or scrum teams, whatever, I see those as their friends. So we need to stick as a family, so there needs to be a family time. And in this family time, we talk about the issues that we have as a team. We support each other as a team, so that everybody feels the power of the whole team behind them. One for all and all for one. And then, of course, I need to be able there to spend time with everybody. So that they are of course also the so-called one-on-ones, where I do spend time talking about things which are I like to call the circle of trust. So that is only between me and my employee and nobody else. Because of the way how I envision the work inside one working week, we start the week with a productive workshop and a kickoff, so to speak, in the quality assurance team. And we end the week with a workshop that it's something like a retrospective. It's not really a retrospective in the sense of a sprint, but it's more of a let's reflect on what we have done, what we have seen, what was the funniest story, for example, that has happened through this week, what did we not like, so that I could catch it up. I could help those people that are in need. And then we finish with a joke about quality assurance or about IT or something like this. In between, we can discuss topics around things that we want to know, how the other teams are doing, or how we could improve ourselves and so on. It's the middle content is always varying. But in the end, the most important thing is that in the end, everybody goes into the weekend on a positive note. That's the most important thing. And I have had enough meetings where people come completely unpleased with completely negative attitude, and after the meeting, they are all smiles and finish the week in a nice way, so that they could enjoy and go through everything that was bad that happened during the week, and just enjoy the weekend and rest up. But there are four questions that I would always like to use as an anchor, as an anchor point to follow up on from time to time, and to see how things are generally moving with the employee. And that's, of course, outside of the scope of the so-called individual development reviews, which are happening once a year and so on. It's how do you feel in the work with your team? And this is not the QA team. That's the team that you work on a regular basis with in the sprint. Then how do you feel in the work with the QA team? How do you feel in the work with me? And how do you feel in the company? And by answering those four questions, there are sometimes three, sometimes four. There could be other questions companies, depending on what kind of position the quality assurance engineer has. By answering those questions, I get an indication of how things are moving. And then it is an indication for me as well, for my own status or my own success with this employee. If next time when we answer those questions and there was something that needed to be addressed, it is already addressed. So I use it for me as well as a guide, how to support, how to help. So flow time is something very important. So it's a time without meetings. Nobody should put any meetings in this time. And then I'm trying to time box the meetings as much as I can, so that there is no overspill. We do cancel meetings if we don't need them. So that's the first. Usually when you start a meeting, there are a couple of questions that you need to answer immediately. That's either if you are focused, if you need a ramp up, if the meeting is necessary, for example, and maybe some others that I don't come up with right now. But each meeting needs to mean something. There needs to be a result after the meeting. And it's been definitely my experience that I have been participating in meetings where nothing happened. I was not pleased by this, of course. But still, sometimes this is also a wrong feeling, because sometimes we need to have more meetings. We need to talk about a topic more times in order to understand it, in order to come to the essence, to understand what the reasons for this are.